everyone, it's Tita Chinita, and today we're going to talk about home office organization. Welcome to the first episode of the home office series. I mentioned dun sa smart living room episode natin that we will be moving on to home makeovers. I wanted to start with the home office. But as I was planning, I realized na hindi ko kayang i-cram, i-compress lahat ng tips and tricks that I wanted to share with you in just one video. So I decided to turn this into a series para shorter videos but jam-packed with practical, useful solutions that can help you organize your home offices. And when I say home office, I don't just mean yung room or area kung nasan yung home office nyo. I would also be sharing with you how I deal with home management tasks that I normally do in the home office. So for example, how to manage your home budget or how to schedule and plan your day. So watch out for those videos. So today we're going to talk about paper clutter. For the longest time, most of our storage solutions were just temporary because we were renting. And syempre, ayoko namang mag-invest on storage solutions na baka by the time na meron na kaming sariling house, hindi naman maging appropriate yung storage solutions na yon for that house. And also for myself, kasi syempre, I'm not the same person that I was 3 or 5 years ago. And what I thought was important back then may not be as important now. And this will factor in kung paano nyo i-organize yung mga gamit nyo. So now that we have our own home, I'm more willing to spend on permanent storage solutions. And kaya natagalan tong video na to kasi pinag-isipan ko talaga kung anong system ba yung gusto kong i-put in place na syempre, budget-friendly pa rin. Very important tip, you can't just grab an idea from Pinterest or from Home Edit or from the internet just because maganda siya. Yung system na isa-setup nyo has to align with your organizing style. So kailangan talagang pag-isipan paano mo ba gagamitin tong system na to. So, share ko sa inyo yung naging thought process ko. So, para tong dichotomous key, where you're given two options and you have to choose one. So, first one, minimalist or abundant? Minimalist if you prefer na konti lang yung mga gamit nyo. Abundant kung medyo marami kayong gamit na minimaintain. Next, macro-organization or micro-organization? Macro if you prefer bigger categories. Micro kung mas gusto mong mas detailed yung categories mo. For example, bank records. Kung macro-organizer ka, lahat ng bank documents mo, naka-contain lang siya in just one folder. Whereas kung micro-organizer ka, naka-divide pa yan, naka-separate per bank. Last, hidden or visual organization. So kung hidden, mas gusto mong nakatago yung mga gamit mo. Opposite sa visual na mas gusto mo na out and in the open. So these organizing styles don't just apply to your home office. You can use this all throughout your home. And you might have noticed that dito sa bahay namin, ang organizing style ko is abundant slash micro slash visual. So we have a lot of items that I organize in smaller categories, pero gusto ko visual para easy access, madaling i-grab and go. So now that we've talked about organizing styles, let's move on to organizing products. And ang magdidictate nito is whether you're macro or micro, and visual or hidden. So kung macro, syempre you need bigger containers because you organize in bigger categories. Whereas micro, you want to find products that would allow you to drill down into your smaller categories. So for macro, siguro better option for you yung mga magazine file holders na marami kayong malalagay na papers. For micro, pwede yung mga filing envelopes na maraming tabs para you can label your categories accordingly. Then, sa hidden, since para sa inyo, clutter kung nakikita nyo yung mga gamit nyo, you can use opaque storage boxes. And para sa mga visual, we can use transparent or translucent storage solutions para hindi tayo na out of sight, out of mind. Gaya ng mga boyfriends at asawa nating naglalaro ng ML.
Game over.
First step sa pag-organize ng paper clutter is, from the word itself, declutter. Assess nyo kung kailangan nyo pa ba yung mga papel na yon, alin yung pwede nyo nang i-dispose, or for example, warranties. Kung dinabi nyo yon and nag-lapse naman na yung warranty nun, what's the point of keeping those, diba? So, tapon nyo na. even papers that you're sentimental about. I mentioned kanina na you're not the same person that you were 5 years ago. Kung sentimental ka about those things 5 years ago, baka ngayon hindi na. So, pwede nang itapon. After decluttering, you can start categorizing. So, either you organize ng macro or ng micro, depending on your style. Then, after categorizing, you can set it up dun sa mga organizing products nyo. For myself, I chose this expanding file organizer from Lazada. 185 each ko lang siya nabili, and this allows me to organize my files in smaller categories. Next step is to label, but this is optional. For some people, ayaw nila ng may label. But for me, essential yung labels para mas madali yung buhay, mas madaling maghanap ng documents, mas madali ding mag-file away. Also, kung may kasama kayo sa bahay and yung file storage na to is common to all, mas madaling maghanap kung may labels. Ang nagastos ko for this project, around 400 pesos for the file organizer plus shipping. Malaki yung natibid ko because I decided to reuse yung mga dati kong file envelopes. The problem was, hindi uniform tong mga envelopes na to. May tendency magmukhang cluttered kasi yung iba fabric, yung iba plastic. So what I did was, yung mga files, documents, records na hindi ko usually na-access, yun yung mga nilagay ko dun sa lumang mga file envelopes. Tapos, nilagay ko tong iba-ibang envelopes na to sa isang fabric storage box. So visually, malinis pa rin tingnan, pero pag pinull out mo yung box, naka-organize pa rin naman per category. So big savings because of this idea. Lesson for the day, make do with what you have. Tip para dun sa may mga open shelving system kagaya nito, medyo high maintenance kasi siya. You have to keep it organized in a certain way, otherwise medyo distracting. So what I did was kumuha ko ng tension rod and nilagyan ko ng curtains and ta-da! This way, malinis pa rin siyang tingnan. And kung may kailangan kang i-access sa loob, madali lang. So that's it for today's video. Stay tuned for more home office tips and hacks. Next up is how I organize my crafting supplies. So panoorin nyo rin yung video na yon. And I hope na-inspire kayo ng video na to organize and make your own spaces beautiful. And if you like this kind of content, please do subscribe and hit the like button. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye!